Hello everyone, my name is jmlisondra and today I'm gonna teach you how to paint this wonderful painting. I will show you here on how to put details on rocks and also on the river. And please don't forget to subscribe, you can subscribe it and hit that bell button if you want to receive some future notification in my new videos and tutorial. And hey everyone, if you want to buy t-shirt, you can purchase my original designs on Teespring. Okay everyone, so you can see all the materials needed on the screen. You can see there the 5 limited colors and also my brushes and then other materials that we're gonna need to paint this tutorial. Okay, so I'm not going to waste my time and I'm going to start right away. So I am gonna do the first step first, of course, and I'm gonna do the sketching. Okay, so I will sketch first using a smaller brush, which is the number 2 flat brush. Okay, maybe I just use this plain raw umber so that it will be dark, but I will not recommend this if you are painting an open area like when there's clouds or something. Okay, so I will do the little sketch first. Maybe I will just lighten this color. There. There will be a big, huge rock here. Okay. Okay, so very first pattern of this rocks. And also there are some small rocks here. So I'll just get the idea. Or where I'm gonna put those rocks. And I'll do my best to put tiny small details just to make those rocks pretty realistic. We are first in the first step, which is the sketching. Some parts will not be shown because there was no space. Okay, so I am done with the first step, which is the sketching, and now I'm going to proceed to the second step, which is adding of underpainting or the background colors. So I'll do first the dark tones. I'll be using the number 8 flat brush and then this raw umber with some blue to create some darker colors. what I like about copying from the photo, because I can make it look closer to natural, realistic color. And also, it will be a little hard for me, of course, even for anyone also, because when you copy from the photo, it takes time, it takes more time, because you need to make sure that all the details are similar. Okay, also here, not maybe not so similar, but it will, it should be close. You can just use the umber straight, everyone. I'm not really sure if I'm going to make this a full tutorial, because I don't really know if I'm going to finish it faster. Big problem with if you are painting from a photo, it will really take time. Okay. Let's try to put some wet paints there. I'm using another big brush, everyone. And I just used this wet pens. So here I add more white. Yeah, I can just cover this part with these colors, thin colors. Okay. Yeah, I can just add water to make it really thin. Hopefully my camera won't shut down, because sometimes shit happens. Okay, then I'm gonna put on the waters like greenish color, so I'm going to use this blue, yellow, and the umber, maybe some red, yeah, and more yellow, and red, yeah. should be more like greenish dark or something. So I'll just fill this part with some greenish because sorry the background a little greenish, yeah. Okay. Blue, yellow, and the umber. Yeah, you just play these colors here. So again everyone, this is just the first step, which is the underpainting. I do not really know how much time I need to finish this one. Okay, I'll put first a little more orange on this part here. It's more brownish or orange. There. And in this part, I'm gonna make it more like bluish gray or something. So blue under umber. And then a little white. One more blue, umber, and then blue. I'll just darken this part first. Okay, everyone, again the same color. It's a bluish gray. There's also rocks on the sides. I'll just put it, make some umber here. Okay everyone, so I think I am done with the underpainting, and now I'm going to proceed with the details. Now first I'm gonna do my best to put details on these rocks. Okay, so I will try to do it here first or something. Yeah, and I will put first some those dark tones colors. I think Umber. See some highlights there. Oh, dark shadows. And then I'm gonna use this umber with a little white. And I'll put a little tiny details here. Using this number 2 flat brush. It's not easy everyone, it will not be very, it will not be easy. Okay, and I'll use this light brown. I'm going to add some white. This light brown first. Yellow and red. Yeah, I mean this part here, it will take me time, I know. That's why I will not make it as realistic as I see in the reference. Too much, yeah. Okay. I'll come back on that later on. I'll just make everything fine first. This rock will be something like smooth rock. There are smooth and also hard rocks. So this one will be one of the smooth rocks. Gonna put some holes there. Okay, so if you're painting with me, you can follow what I'm doing, or you can just watch, because I think this will be really advanced tutorial for everyone. Okay. Okay, so I have now here, and now I'm gonna use a little greenish, so blue and yellow, or yellow with a little red. I'll make this part greenish. Maybe I'll just try to change my brush. Okay. This one is a little sharper, but still the same size. But it's new one. Okay, so here I'm going to make it. Okay, this one will be a little darker. And I will try to put some highlights, but it will be a little more light or light greens, so I'll just add yellow and white here. So here also, we're gonna put some greenish color. Gonna put some greenish tone on this rock on the top. The greenish should be like more reddish and or yellow. I'll put my yellow. There. I'm going to continue adding more details on the rocks. Continue adding more greenish tone here. Okay, using this small brush, you could even use smaller, and then also here. I think I'll use this. I'll just put some darker tones. Okay, and then I will use yellow and red, more red and white. First, I'm gonna put it here. It will be a little reddish on the top of this rock, but it should be light enough, everyone. Lights here. Okay, yeah, just a little, everyone. Don't put too much. Anyway, we still have more time for retouching, but not now. I'll use some raw umber. Put caps here. Okay. Can I see in this part, it looks more, looks now realistic. There. And now we're gonna retouch this rock. I'm gonna do my best to make this rock look realistic. I'm going to darken this part here. Okay, I think I'm gonna need to go closer. There. And I do first those dark tones. Those dark parts, and then after that we're gonna do the highlights. Highlights will make me more excited, because when you put the highlights, slowly the painting will pop out. little lighter color. There are two small rocks here. To do it slowly. Now I'm gonna put more, a little reddish. And another dark tones here. Okay. And then we'll start putting those highlights. I'm gonna use some more white. You can make the topping because I think this rock plenty of holes. Okay, and now I'll be using a little on this reddish brown. I just do my best, everyone, to make it this tutorial as fast as possible. Okay. Yeah, I think I need more dark tones like umber and blue. This time, a little darker. Not just a little darker, but way darker. Okay. And then I need a little more greenish. Okay, and then I will put some rocks like this using this through umber only. Okay, everyone, so I do not know if it's good for me and also for you that I make tutorials now very long, but you can comment below if you are okay with this, if you are okay with very long tutorials like this. Please let me know everyone, so that I can also adjust the kind of tutorials I can give it to you. Maybe I'll just give it to you some simple tutorials, easy for beginners. But I want also to give you like this type of tutorials. It's really very complicated and plenty of details there. But this one, everyone, is from Photo. Yeah. And of course, the results will be more beautiful than those ordinary materials that just come from my mind. Okay, so I think those rocks there are really good. It looks really realistic when you watch this at a good distance. So far it's really good tutorial, everyone. It's really good, yeah. Okay, so of course I'm going to continue. And then I'm gonna do more. Okay, so I will do this one first, then I'm going to proceed to putting this water. Okay, so I will do first the dark tones as usual, raw umber and blue, Here I'm going to put a little light, but I'll be using the umber and white. Okay, and then I will try a little greenish color. So yellow and blue with red, and then yellow and more red. I think more reddish. Again, another yellow. There, I like this one. Can I use the topping like that? Topping will create textures on your rock, so it's better. So. Also here. There. And then this one. Okay. Then I'll try also these rocks. So I will not, on this distance, I will not make it so complicated. Let's make it like blurred or something. Okay. Yeah, I will add more like those the dark tones. I will put more umber. Just remember everyone. And put it there a little more slowly. Okay, raw umber and blue to make it darker. Okay, and now I'm going to mix for a little more gray, yes. I'll put it here. Just a little gray as everyone. Okay, and then I'll be using again just this light brown here, and I'll adding some white. Thank you. That's all right. So another, I think I will mix yellow and red to make an orange, another orange everyone. And I will add more white, not too much white. Also here. Okay, let's do it little by little, everyone. You can actually use a smaller brush like the number one liner brush, better for detailing. But in my case, I want it to be faster, so I want to finish it faster. That's why I'll still be using the big brush. Okay, so we need to put a little greenish color. Let's make this part darker. Okay, I think I like this. Yeah, I think this will really take me much more time, everyone. But yeah, as I said, the result, I think it's worth it. Okay, so now I'll be adding details on these parts. So first, I'm gonna mix for a little grayish, not just a little, but grayish color, raw umber and blue, and then I'm gonna put some white. And add more blue. This for the water, everyone. I think I will add more white. I think it will add more umber. Yeah, I'll just get the idea, everyone, and put some random stops there. I think I'll try like the color. You can create a very chaotic details. As you can see on the reference. It will not be easy, everyone, but yeah, it's worth a try. You can try also. Actually, it's better just to use the very small brush. Okay, I will try to put more white. There are plenty of chaotic waves here, rushing. Okay. Later when we're gonna use a smaller brush for this. I think the smaller brush would fit for this one. Okay, I think I'm gonna use another smaller brush. And in here, I need to make it small and tiny. And then also here. And create some zigzag waves there. There. Yeah, so far I like it, everyone. For me, it really look realistic. I'll add more. I'm gonna make it a little darker with a little blue. I'm gonna add more blue and white. I think I want it darker. I will be using a bigger brush now. I want to make the process faster. Yeah. So I'll be using the number 8 flat brush. And I have here a little lighter blue. Everything in this water event is chaos. I'll just do my best to make it similar to what I copied. But also here. On this part here, and then put a little light reflections. I'll try to smudge. It should look more chaotic, everyone. That's why I just smudge this part. Smudge. I'll put a little bluish. Okay. Yeah, but I'm going to put some umber or red to make it more like purple. I want lighter. Okay. Yeah, I like how it looks in the screen, everyone. But I'm not yet contented. I'm going to put more. It should be much more realistic. Okay. I'll now try to add some darker tones. Through umber, blue, and yellow. More red. Especially in the water, everyone. I'll try to put more. More shades. On this part also. And here. And then I'll try to use some darker color. I will make this part a little darker. And then some red and yellow. More red to make it more look like orange. I'll put it here. And then this one, I'm gonna make it brownish. Okay, everyone, so I will try to put a little more details. I'll try to use the liner brush now. Going to put details on the waves. Okay, I'm going to put first the white. There. I want to put more water to make it fluid. highlights. Okay. I'll just put some more highlights there. It's gonna be really, really plenty of work. Okay, I'm going to make it a little darker because I think this is too much light, everyone. I think that looks like realistic in the photo, everyone. But that will make it further more realistic. Yeah, I'm going to use this. It should be a little lighter. It's gonna be a lot of work, everyone. Okay, so let's continue adding details. So I think I will just use purple, light purple. Okay. And then this one also. Put a white one. This is actually a plain white. And also this one, this part. More. Okay. There should be more highlights, everyone. Not just few, but plenty of lights. You can just do like this. And then using these light colors, I'm going to put some rushing waters here. Yeah, I just put as plenty of highlights as I could, and also I'm going to mix for raw umber with blue, or I think purple. Yeah, then a little raw umber and white. I'm going to put some highlights here. Yeah, to look like a shiny rocks, everyone. Okay, I think that looks pretty much more realistic now. I'm going to continue adding more highlights here. Just put more a little highlights on this part, everyone. And then I will put put some dark tones. But first I will try to use this umber on red and yellow. I think I'll put more umber and blue. There. And it also here. Some dark tones, or just to make this part look realistic. Okay, everyone, I'm going to put more bluish gray, I think, here. I just started to put some darker shades there, everyone. Okay, I want more. If I'm going to do everything on the photo, it will really take me time, maybe estimated one, if I'm going to seriously copy everything, like really very close. It might take me like 5 to 10 hours, I think, just to make it look more like what we see in the photo. Okay, so I'm almost done, and I think so far it's really good for me. As of now, it looks really pretty realistic. Yeah, the rocks, and I'll just retouch everyone and I'm done. Okay. Now I'm going to put some more details on the rocks and I will be finished. Yeah, I will not really make this part here. And also here. So maybe I'll just retouch this one, everyone, offline. I will make this much more realistic. But for the tutorial, I think this will be fine for me. Just a little retouch and I am done. Light Umber. And to smudge with my fingers. Try to also to put some lighter highlights here. This rock looks like wet, and we're gonna put some highlights there that it will look like a reflecting, and also some. And in here, using the umber and red and a little yellow, I'll put something here that looks like shadow. Or just a umber. And a little highlights. Okay, everyone, so I think I am done, and I think it's almost 1 hour 30 minutes, and so far, everyone, I really contented with the result. It looks really realistic for me now. I really like the finish of this one. So far it looks great and looks realistic, and I hope you also like this and you get something out of this. So I just want to show you here, it's just a simple tutorial. I want to show you how to put plenty of details to make your painting realistic. Okay, so if I'm going to put more time here, maybe like another 5 hours or for 5 hours or 10 hours, it will be much more detailed and much more closer to the photo, much more realistic.
Okay everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like and some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praise always belongs to the Lord.